See the next topic. Adsorption of solutes from solutions. Till now we have discussed about adsorption of gases on the solid surface. Right now we discuss about adsorption of solutes from the solution. In solution, see some examples. Some colored dyes are present in aqueous solution. When these colored dyes present in water are shaken with some adsorbents like activated charcoal or animal charcoal or some freshly prepared precipitates. So when a colored dye aqueous solution is shaken with an adsorbent, the color of that solution becomes pale after some time and finally it becomes colorless. What is the reason why there is decrease in the intensity of a color of the solution when it is shaken with the adsorbent? Why it is finally colorless? Yes, because of adsorption. When you shake the colored solution with the adsorbent, that adsorbent adsorbs the solute particles, color causing solute particles in the solution. So because of that, solutes all get adsorbed. That's why number of solute particles causing color in the solution decreases. So when there is decrease in the concentration of the solute, color also becomes pale. And finally, the solution becomes colorless. When all the solute particles are adsorbed, it becomes colorless. Okay, so for the adsorption of solutes, that means colored particles from the solution, which are good adsorbents? See, here also finely divided solids, porous solids are the good adsorbents. Finely divided solids, porous solids are the good adsorbents. So in the adsorption of solutes from solution, which are good adsorbents? Finely divided porous solids and freshly prepared precipitates. Freshly prepared precipitates . These are the finely divided solids, porous solids and freshly prepared precipitates acts as good adsorbents. Okay, let's see some examples. For acetic acid in aqua solution, CH3COOH, aqua, which is good adsorbent for it? Yes, animal charcoal, when it is added to the aqua solution of acetic acid and it is shaken thoroughly, concentration of acetic acid in water decreases. Why? Because of adsorption. Similarly, colored dyes in an organic dye in aqua solution, for this which is activated charcoal, or here also we can use animal charcoal. Activated charcoal is the good adsorbent. There is an organic dye, magnesium. From its aqua solution, magnesium is a blue colored dye. Which color? Blue colored dye it is. When this magnesium is dissolved in water, solution gets blue color. So when it is shaken with magnesium hydroxide, magnesium hydroxide is a colorless solid. Freshly prepared magnesium hydroxide, if added to this magnesium aqua solution and it is shaken thoroughly, what happens is NGOH twice, which is a colorless substance, gets a blue color. Why? Because it's a colorless substance. It gets blue color. What is the reason? This colorless magnesium hydroxide adsorbs the blue colored magnesium particles on its surface. So because of that, even though magnesium hydroxide is colorless, it gets blue color. So these are some examples for adsorbents which adsorb solutes from the solution. What are the conditions for this type of adsorption? Here also we follow the same points that we follow in the adsorption of gases on solid surface. What are the basic points that we followed in the adsorption of gases on solid surface? Here also, see, extent of adsorption in the solution is also directly proportional to surface area. Directly proportional to surface area. That means if the adsorbent, that is maybe animal charcoal, activated charcoal or magnesium hydroxide, if the adsorbent is having more surface area, it can have more adsorbent on its surface. So here also proportionality. Just like adsorption of gases on solid surface, adsorption of solutes from the solution also directly proportional. Similarly, extent of adsorption in this case is inversely proportional to temperature, just like physical adsorption. In physical adsorption, what happens? With increase in temperature, extent of adsorption decreases. Next, extent of adsorption, what is the formula? Already from Freundlich adsorption isotherm, what is the formula? There we wrote x by m is equal to k into p power 1 by m. But here we write k into c power 1 by m. Here also k and n are constraints. K and these two are constraints. Okay. What is c here? It is equilibrium, adsorption equilibrium concentration, or simply equilibrium concentration. Equilibrium concentration it is. Okay, so we can write here logarithmic form also. How to write logarithmic form for the above equation? Log of x by m equals to, log of x by m equals to 1 by n into log c plus log k. That means this adsorption from solution also follows the same principles that we followed in adsorption of gases on solid surface. Okay, but only difference is there in the case of adsorption of gases on solid surface, there is pressure term. But in solutions, we use concentration term. Okay, so this is about adsorption of solutes from solutions.